So what I'm basically arguing here is that we can think of reinforcement learning as a kind of planning. It's not learning at all. It's actually planning in a kind of continuous space POMDP, where the hidden state is the set of parameters of the MDP that we're trying to learn. Now, there's an infinite number of those, which makes things a little bit awkward, and so we don't really get the piecewise linear and convex property anymore, but it can be shown that you can actually get a result that shows that the value function in this continuous space POMDP is actually piecewise polynomial and convex.
Okay.
You know, it's not as nice as linear, but it's still representable.
How big is the degree of that polynomial?
It grows with iterations of value iteration.
I see.
Yeah. So it's not like piecewise cubic and convex. It's like piecewise, it could be a lot of degree, depending on how many iterations you do. So this is still pretty awkward to work with. There's an algorithm that actually works fairly nicely called Beetle that tries to approximate this piecewise polynomial and convex function and can sometimes actually end up learning very good approximations of the optimal way to do reinforcement learning for those spaces of problems.
Does Beetle stand for something?
Bayesian exploration exploitation trade-off in learning.
Which is cheating. I think we agree.
Yeah. But otherwise it would be like Beetle, which would be just way too hard to say.
Bayesian exploration exploitation trade-off in learning everything.
The E for everything.
Yeah, and then that would be better. I think I could forgive that.
Learning excellently.
No, that's too many. That's just absurd.
The point that I'd like to make, though, or the point of this slide, is that there are Bayesian RL algorithms. Beetle is one of them. It is not by any means the only one. There's lots of different ways that people have looked at actually keeping Bayesian posteriors over the MDPs that are being learned, and then trying to use that Bayesian posterior to make better decisions than you would in just, you know, reinforcement learning, where you don't have any kind of prior, any kind of structure on what the possible underlying MDP is. So a lot of people really like this stuff. It seems to, at the moment, be on the side of just kind of too expensive to be practically useful. Q-learning seems to tend to win. But it's very elegant, and it's a useful way of sort of realizing that planning and learning actually are two sides of the same coin.
We've used it before in some work that I've done.
Oh, okay.
But what we were taking advantage of is the fact that it gives you probability distributions over value functions, or rather over Q functions.
How does it do that?
So you're in a state, and it just tells you basically the probability of an action being optimal. And that turns out to be very nice, because you can then compare various sources of information together, because they're all, if you can make them all look like probabilities.
Oh, that sounds like that really cool policy sort of merging paper that I saw.
Yeah, that one.
Is that you?
Yes, by Isabel and his colleagues.
Woo!